Thank you. This is my great honor to talk to you. So, I will explain my question in Japanese first to the audience right here. Then I'm gonna ask you the question. Is that okay? Okay. So, それではインタビュー始めさせていただきます。まずは、Björk さん、なぜ、この Kimono Roboto のプロジェクトに参加をされたのか、その理由を伺いたいと思います。So, first of all, please tell us what made you to decide to collaborate with this exhibition, Kimono Robot, and how it started?
Yeah, it was a mutual love, maybe, for kimonos. Mm-hmm. And I think your people reached out to me, I think partly because in different contexts than the traditional Japanese way. So I thought this was very interesting and decided to collaborate, or just to celebrate the best of sound. For me, on my albums, is to have a human voice, and to have harps, and to have flutes, and then to have electronic programming. And I am sure that in kimono making, you can embrace the same things. I used in the past and worn a 3D printed masks and 3D printed dresses, and I am sure that with some incredible robotic craftsmanship, it would be possible to unite the old crafts of the original kimono making. I'm very excited about Christmas. I'm starting to decorate. I would just like to enjoy your craft, your kimono weaving, making, embroidery, beautiful craft, and feel proud and enjoy your tradition and how you magnificently have merged it with 2017, and thank you very much.
Thank you very much. So next one, Björk さん今ご覧いただいて分かるようにですね、独特のスタイルからメッセージを発信されているんですけども、日本のファッションについてこう何を感じ、どんな影響を受けているか、また着物というものについてどのように感じておられるかということを伺っていきたいと思います。By the way, your headpiece is just gorgeous, stunning. And your style, you are always communicating with audience with your unique style. What part of Japanese fashion would you get inspired from? Especially, what do you think about kimono? What part of Japanese fashion style would you get inspiration?
Well, ever since I started coming to Japan, which is now a long time ago, when I was in the sugar industry in the 80s, I've been blown away by Japanese visuals. And I actually was going to learn, I applied for a Japanese animation school when I was 18. That didn't happen because I ended up going to bands and being in music. I think it's hard to choose something, but obviously I have always been a huge admirer of Conte Carson and Jimmy Watanabe
やっぱり自然との融合、そういうことを私は、信じておりますし、日本はそういう意味で言ったらとっても、自分の中では尊敬できる、国だと思っていますので、本当に、近くに感じております。
I hope you come back to Japan pretty soon.